charity. And then it says, if these things be in you and about, they make you that ye shall neither be barren nor fruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. But he that lacketh these things is blind and cannot see afar off, and has forgotten that he was purged from his old sins. Wherefore the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and your election sure. For it is, if ye do these things, ye shall never fall. You'll never fall. For so an entrance shall be ministered unto you abundantly into the everlasting kingdom of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Something new is happening to you this year. In Ephesians chapter 4, I'm reading from verse 21. Ephesians chapter 4, we're reading from verse 21. If so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him, as the truth is in Jesus, and that ye put off concerning the former conversation the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful laws, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind. This year, we're going to be renewed. In fact, we're renewed already. And you will show it to your brother when you come out of the service this morning. You greet him in a new way. Show it to your sister when you come out of the service this morning. You think about her in a new way and greet her in a new way and be nice in a new way. And if you do that, when you do it over and over and over again, you'll find that it becomes a habit, and everybody will say, well, she's good, we're going to be good to her. You're good to 100 people, and when 100 people are good to you, until this year is going to be good. And then verse 23, it says in verse 23, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind. And then it says, and that she put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and, tell me the rest. Tell me again. True holiness. If there is true holiness, there is false holiness. You know, there are some people, they go back to history many years ago. I was saved 20 years ago. I was sanctified 19 years ago. I was made holy 19 years ago. But it says true holiness, false holiness. What's false holiness? Being haughty. What's false holiness? Being offensive. What's false holiness? Being lustful, lusting in their hearts. And they say, I was sanctified many years ago. H, haughty. O, offensive. L, lusting. I, incorrigible. He was sanctified. She was sanctified many years ago, but she is incorrigible. N, negligent. False holiness. E, evil, envious, false holiness. And S, sensual. Another S, self-centered. But the Lord is saying that this year will not be a year of false holiness. Have you found some religious people? Those religious people, the way they walk and the way they talk and the resolutions they make and the things they say and the way they open their Bible, and when you call the name of Jesus, the way they will bend down and everything looks sanctimonious as if they are the holy, holy people. But they are haughty. They are offensive. They have lust. They are incorrigible. They are negligent. They are envious and evil, sensual, self-centered. What's true holiness? Humility without haughtiness. What's true holiness? Obedience without offense. What's true holiness? Love without lust. What's true holiness? Incorruptibility without incorrigibility. What's true holiness? Nobility without negligence. What's true holiness? Exemplary life without envy. What's true holiness? Spirituality without sensuality. What's true holiness? Sanctification without self-centeredness. That's what the Lord is telling us, that this year will be a year of holiness. And the year of holiness will be the year of happiness in Jesus' name. It will be the year of a great harvest. It will be the year of a great health and good health. And the Lord will accomplish it in your life, in my life, in our church, in Jesus' name. Humble, not haughty, obedient, not offensive, loving, not lusting, incorruptible, not incorrigible, noble, not negligent, exemplary, not able, not envious, spiritual, not sensual, sanctified, not self-centered. Point number three, now pursue the delight of your new master. Pursue the delight of your new master. In Psalm 63, I'm reading from verse 1. Psalm 63. What do you mean from verse 1? Oh God, thou art my God. Only when I seek thee, my soul thirsteth for thee. My flesh longeth for thee in a dry land where there is no water. To see thy power and thy glory, so as I have seen thee in the sanctuary, because thy loving kindness is better than life. My lips shall praise thee. This year you will praise the Lord. You're pursuing and you're seeking after the Lord. You're thirsty and you're hungry for the presence of the Lord. That presence will be manifested in your life in Jesus' name. Psalm 69, verse 31, verse 32. Psalm 69, verse 31. This also shall please the Lord better than an ox or bullock that hath horns and hoofs. The humble shall see this and be glad, and your heart shall live that seek God. Your heart shall live that seek after God, pursuing after the delights of the new man. In Psalm 27, reading from verse 1, Psalm 27, reading from verse 1, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came near, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and they fell. They will stumble and fall in your life. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war shall rise against me, in this will you be confident. I said you'll be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord. How many days? All the days of my life, and to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. Verse 8, when thou saidst, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Thy face, Lord, will I seek. The people that pursue the lights of the Lord, your life will be a delight. Psalm 70, I'm reading from verse 4. Psalm 70, reading from verse 4. Psalm 70, verse 4. Seeking the Lord, pursuing the things that please him. Psalm 70, verse 4. Let all those that seek thee rejoice and be glad in thee. And let such as love thy salvation say continually, let the Lord, let God be magnified. God will be magnified in your life. And then we're looking at Colossians chapter 3. Colossians chapter 3. Our pursuit for this year. Our thirst for this year. The things we seek this new year. Our passion, pursuit, priority for this year. Colossians chapter 3, reading there from verse 1. Colossians chapter 3, from verse 1. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above. Since you are risen with Christ, your sins are forgiven. The blood of Jesus has washed you whiter than snow. Your life is renewed, and the atonement of Christ on the cross of Calvary has done something in your heart, in your life. And it says, because of that, and now you have died with him, you have been buried with him, and you have risen with him. Seek those things which are above, where Christ is seated on the right hand of God. the things above are the things you seek. And you ask yourself, what were you seeking last year? The things on earth. How much of that did you get? Not much, not much, not much. Turn around and seek the things above. Set your affections on things above and not on things on the earth. For your life, for ye are dead and your life is hid with Christ in God. Set your affections on things above. As we're going to pray about spiritual things, about material things, don't worry, those things will come later. I said they'll come later. But you know, your salvation, make sure you're saved beyond any shadow of doubt. Your sanctification, make sure you're sanctified beyond any shadow of doubt. And the power of the Spirit of God upon your life, make sure that the baptism is there, the anointing, the unction, the power, the fire is there. By the grace of God, set your affection on things above, on the second coming, set your affection on that. On the reward you are going to have in heaven, set your affection on that. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. And then it says in verse 4, when Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall he also appear with him in glory. You'll be there. 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 8. Finally, be all of one mind. Unity. We're going to have it this year. We have it already. Finally, be all of one mind, having compassion one of another. One of another. And that's a two-way traffic. Two-way traffic. And you know, there are some people that want everybody in this is, be kind to me, be kind to me. Hey, it's a two-way traffic. Be kind to other people too. There are some people that should, every time there's a coordinator and, you know, members of and workers in the church, and they say, there's no love again, there's no love again. I remember when the house fellowship started, there was so much love. Because, you know, people used to give me this and give me this and give me this. They don't give me anymore. It's not a one-way traffic. It's a two-way traffic. Be kind to others if you want them to be kind to you. And be loving to others just like you want them to be loving and nice to you. And be compassionate on other people as you want them to be compassionate on you. And then also go to the house fellowship. If you want to see love in the house fellowship, it's not just the one-way traffic, give me, give them too. And make sure that what you expect from other people, you too, you are giving, having compassion one of another. Love as brethren. Be pitiful and be courteous. You know, sometimes as we, you know, have the service now in this new year, wonderful service it is in Jesus' name. You know, somebody will go out there after the service and say, you know, the church, look at the church. With all those things that the pastor preached and the pastor said, let's be merciful to one another, let's be kind. You know, nobody even smiled at me. I was, you know, standing there thinking whether somebody will come and say, Happy New Year, how are you? But, you know, they just looked at me and, you know, I tested them. I frowned my face. I thought, you know, they're obeying the pastor. They're waiting for you to obey you. When you do, the rest of us will follow in Jesus' name. Be in the front of the queue and smile first. And show the kindness first. And show the love first. And show the good attitude first. Don't wait for the rest of us. Why are you not in the front of the queue to show us the example? When you do it, the rest of us will follow in Jesus' name. And then it says in verse 9, not rendering evil for evil, or railing for railing, but contrary wise blessing, knowing that ye are thereunto called, that ye should inherit a blessing. You will inherit a blessing. For he that will love life and see good days, let him refrain his tongue from evil, and his tongue and his lips from speaking guile. And let him eschew evil, hate evil, reject evil, and do good. And let him seek peace and do what? And see it, pursue it. For the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous, and his ears are open to their prayers. The ears of the Lord will be open to your prayer. But his face is against them that do evil. Matthew chapter 6, Matthew chapter 6, we're looking at verse 31. Matthew 6, verse 31. Matthew 6, verse 31. Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat? What shall we drink? Or wherewith shall we be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that ye have need of all these things. But seek ye first, what? The kingdom of God, and what? And his righteousness. You know, there are some people, they say, well, it's that righteousness I don't like. I like riches, I like wealth, I like prosperity, I like miracle, I like healing, I like deliverance, but you know, holiness, that one, I don't like that one. But you know, that's the very root of what will bring all the blessings to your life. That's why Jesus said, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and then tell me the rest. All these things shall be added unto you. They are coming this year in Jesus' name. Jeremiah chapter 29, I'm reading from verse 11. Jeremiah chapter 29, reading from verse 11. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace for you this year, and not of evil for you this year, to give you an expected edge this year. Then ye shall call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. Every prayer, every petition will be answered in Jesus' name. And ye shall seek me, and ye shall find me, when ye shall search for me with how? All your heart. This year, prayers are going to be answered. Lives are going to be transformed. Righteousness will flow in our lives like waters in the river in Jesus' name. There'll be righteousness, there'll be holiness, and then there's going to be abundant blessing upon every life in Jesus' name. Remember what the Lord wants us to be and what he wants us to do. He wants us to be new men, new women, new boys, new girls this year, with new attitude, a new beginning, a new courage, a new direction, a new expectation, a new focus, a new guide, a new hospitality, a new interpretation, a new journal, a new key. That key's in your hand already. A new look, a new mind, a new nature, a new object, and a new patience, new questions, a new relationship, a new sincerity, a new tongue, a new unity, a new vision, a new walk, a new x-ray, a new year, a new zeal. And then, if Jesus tarries and I see you at the end of this year, you'll tell me 2010 was the best year I ever lived in my life. It will be so in Jesus' name. It will be unto us according to our faith. Let's rise up and talk to the Lord in prayer. New year has come. New blessing has come. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord in prayer. Reject the old. Reveal the new. Put off the old, put on the new. The old priest forsaking, the old prophet run away from him, the old passion, stop that. The old parables, the old proverbs, the old practices, get rid of them.